Once there was a little old lady named Miss Sara, who lived all alone in a small house near a big farm in the country. Although she was quite old, she was still very active for her age and kept herself busy all day long doing little odds and ends of things about the house and tending her flower garden. She was very happy. Now, some people who knew Miss Sara thought she was just a bit odd, very sweet and nice, mind you, but just a bit odd. You see, Miss Sara kept a rather strange pet in her kitchen. She kept a little pig. Now, of course, there's nothing strange about little pigs, not at all. But most of the time, pigs live in pig pens, not in kitchens. And so Miss Sara kept a pig in her kitchen, and she was considered just a bit odd. Now, Miss Sara was very fond of her pig. She called it Dear Sir and took very good care of it. Every day, she'd give it a bath in a wooden wash tub and always fed it well on clover leaves and clover stalks and scraps from off her table. Dear Sir liked living with Miss Sara and was very happy and contented. Every day, after he had had his bath and had eaten all that he could hold, he'd sprawl out on the kitchen floor and go to sleep. It was a very pleasant life. One day while Dear Sir, the little pig, was sleeping, Miss Sara came into the kitchen and stood looking around with a puzzled look on her face. "I just can't understand it," she said to herself. "I have a strange feeling. I have the strange feeling that this kitchen is getting smaller. But no, that's impossible. Rooms don't shrink. Of course not. That's ridiculous. But my goodness, it does feel smaller. This kitchen really does feel smaller than it used to be. Now, I wonder what makes it feel that way." And Miss Sara sat down on her old rocking chair and rocked and rocked and rocked and thought and thought and thought. Until all of a sudden, she stopped rocking and sat quite still. Suddenly, she knew why the kitchen felt smaller. The pig was getting bigger. That was the answer. The pig was getting bigger. And it was. It really was. And that's not surprising when you think about it, because pigs like to eat, and when they eat, they grow. And Dear Sir liked to eat and eat and eat and eat and eat, so he grew. He wasn't a little pig anymore. He was a big pig, a very big pig. And since he was so big, he took up quite a lot of room in Miss Sarah's small kitchen. This was why the kitchen felt smaller. "Dear me," said Miss Sarah, "I'll have to do something about this." So she went over to the pig and gently woke him up. Then she sat down beside him and had a nice heart-to-heart talk with him. "Dear sir," she said, "I have a problem. As you surely know by now, I'm extremely fond of you, and I've enjoyed having you live with me here in my little kitchen. But, dear sir, you've gotten big, very big, and there just isn't room for you here anymore. I'm awfully sorry. Please forgive me, but you'll just have to live somewhere else." And the poor old lady started to cry. "Now, now, Miss Sara," said the pig, "don't you feel badly. Everything is going to be all right. I understand your problem. I'm a big pig now, and I can understand a lot of things. So don't you worry, you sweet old head. I'll just move over to Mr. Jones' farm and live in his pig pen. Mr. Jones is a very nice man. He has a nice pig pen. I'm sure I'll like it fine." "Oh, thank you, dear sir," said Miss Sara. "You're so understanding. I'll come and visit you every day and bring you the nicest clover leaves and clover stalks in the field. I'll save you all my choicest table scraps, too." And so that's the way it happened. The pig went over to Mr. Jones' farm and lived in Mr. Jones' pig pen with Mr. Jones' pigs. The other pigs were very fond of Dear Sir and were extremely nice to him. They even offered to share their own food with him. But Dear Sir would always thank them politely and say, "No, thank you, friends. If you don't mind, I'll eat later when Miss Sara comes." And so he'd wait. But he never had to wait long. For every day, just as sure as the sun rises, Miss Sara would arrive with her apron full of clover leaves and clover stalks and scraps from off her table. And as Dear Sir enjoyed his food, Miss Sara would talk to him and scratch his back. And so it went for many, many happy days. Mr. Jones, the farmer, was happy. The other pigs were happy. Dear Sir was happy. And Miss Sara was happy. It was all very pleasant.